I'm combing up my hair that is filled with argan oil. My hair has been abnormally dry lately, and so I literally have just been like drenching my ends with argan oil. I don't know if that's gonna do anything, but hopefully it helps. Kyle is holding Maisie right now and doing awake time, because we do awake time for 30 minutes after I feed her. And I'm just gonna clip my hair up because it's,
oh my gosh.
Because it's interesting. So this is so exciting. This is my first vlog since the baby. She really likes the windows and the ceiling lights.
So that's like what she stares at in the mornings.
Okay, I'm gonna make myself some coffee, and we're watching the prayer room, which is our church. A few days a week in the morning they do this, and we just have been watching it on live stream. Every morning has consisted of Starbucks cold brew and my Neptod's vanilla creamer. This is actually like really, really good cold brew. I feel like coffee lovers would be like repulsed that we are drinking this, but we're big coffee lovers, coffee snobs, and that's actually pretty dang good. It's just also extremely convenient. So in another vlog, I showed these ice cube trays. I love the ice cubes, they're so fun, but they're so difficult to get out, or it just takes forever to get them out, so it's such a pain. Oh my gosh, cold. Now I'm gonna make some toast. I have toast every morning. We went to a like a bakery coffee shop to get like good sourdough the other week. And I much prefer that over this, but the bakery is really far. But I do want to learn how to make my own sourdough. So my friend who makes sourdough at home all the time said she wants to have me and another friend over and like show us how to, my voice just cracked, show us how to like make it. Do you want anything for breakfast?
No,
thank you. No turkey bacon? So I thought I'd do like 24 hours. What is on my face? Is that a pimple? Is that a pimple? What? Why is it so dark? I have been having little breakouts like everywhere the past like couple days, and I never break out like that. I'm like, what am I doing? So I wanted to do like 24 hours with a newborn and kind of just show you guys what a day with Maisie looks like. All days are different. Some days she's like on the dot of our schedule, and then other days she's not at all. Like yesterday, she was not at all. I have a super short appointment at 12:15. And so she's gonna stay here with Kyle. And then I also really wanna redo my nails. I do my own dip at home. Ouch! What the heck is happening? We're gonna put her down in about 15 minutes. I'm just gonna finish my breakfast and watch prayer room. So I'm about to hop in the shower. Kyle put her down like almost 20 minutes ago. When we put her down, she's usually still like awake for a while. I watch her on like my monitor, and her eyes are open for like 20 minutes, maybe more than that. I also need to say, my shirt doesn't just say never fail. It says on the back, promises never fail. Like God's promises never fail. But I've made this shirt into a sleep shirt now because I never want to wear it in public because I feel like people are just gonna like see the never fail and be like, what the heck? So I feel like I just need to clear that up. Pour myself another coffee, the second coffee of the day. So my next feeding I would like to do at 11. So she ate at 8:30, a little later than I wanted, but that was my bad. I didn't get up early enough. She ate till 9, awake time from 9 to 9:30, and then nap from 9:30 to 11. So an hour and a half nap, which makes it 2.5 hours total. Okay, I just got out of the shower. I'm gonna put a mask on because I seriously don't know what's going on with my skin. I literally one night was just like washing my face and I noticed all these like little tiny bumps on my forehead. And so I'm just trying to figure out like, what did I use? What am I eating? Is it just like postpartum, my like hormones changing and like it's just showing up on my face? I don't know. I wanna figure it out. Honestly, this mask probably isn't gonna do anything, but it makes me feel better. I have been watching like hair TikToks of like girls that have like unbelievably beautiful, soft, bouncy hair. And it's very interesting. The products I keep seeing are that like Shea Moisture brand from Target, which literally is the brand of this argan oil. If you know me, you know I'm not an advocate for using drugstore products on your hair because most of them are not good for your hair and will just strip them and coat them and it's not good. But everybody is like using these Shea Moisture products and I'm like, okay, are they like really good actually? Or are people just like blessed with really nice hair and they're saying that it's Shea Moisture? Yeah, definitely wearing a hat to my appointment. Sorry, I just kind of went on like a tangent about nothing baby related. But I mean, the point of this vlog is just to kind of show you guys like actually what a day with a newborn looks like and not like just the parts of the baby or whatever. Cause I feel like before I had her, I wish I watched vlogs that like showed the things that people do in the day and like how the timing of their day works. I'm sure there are vlogs that were like that, but I just didn't find them. Cause there still like are so many aspects of my life that aren't different, like that I still get to do every day, which people would say all the time, like that I'm not gonna have time to take a shower, I'm not gonna have time to do a face mask, to like do my makeup or anything, and I'm like, I'm doing it. But I understand fully that a lot of people actually have a really hard time with doing that. And I talked about that in my last video. So I do wanna direct you there if you haven't watched it. I basically just talked about how the first few weeks have been and like why we do things the way we do, how we've implemented a schedule and everything. So yeah, I highly recommend you just go watch that and hopefully it'll give like context to a lot of what I'm doing today. Okay, perfect timing. She literally just started fussing and it's 10:56. Hello. Oh, so she's been pretty gassy. And so I try to get some, oh, there we go. I try to get some toots out before I change her. Ooh. Look at her little feet. She always like brings her feet up so her feet come out of the thing. What? Oh, I am vlogging. You want me to stop for a second? He's in the shower, or he's coming out of the shower. Okay. So we only have a one bedroom. So she just sleeps with us, but babies usually when they're little, stay in your room for a while anyways. So yeah, we just like took one of the drawers from our dresser on Kyle's side. Kyle sacrificed a drawer, and this is just where like all of our diapers are and wipes and stuff. And then her changing pad is on top of the dresser. So right now she has like a really bad rash on her butt. We have the Bordeaux butt paste that we've been using, but that's in the diaper bag. So I just have like Vaseline. And I've been using Vaseline for the past few days and I actually think it's working okay. So I always change her first thing when she wakes up, right before she eats. so that she's in a clean diaper. Bring it back over.
Oh, is that poop?
Yeah. Oh well, it's dried. It's like a little spot of poop on her.
Yeah.
Okay. So I have to get all of my feeding supplies. It's gonna be really difficult. So I have to have, oh my gosh, I have to have my water. I'm not gonna drop her. I've got her tight on my arm. So I have to have my water, my burp cloth, and my phone because I use like a timer app on my phone that I will show you in a bit. Okay, so the app is called Baby Tracker. This is what it looks like. Okay, okay, I'm going. On the feeding one, there's like a left side and a right side, so in a, it's a timer. So you can time how long you did on each side. And then another kind of feature that's nice about it is it will tell you which side you started on, so that for the next time you can start on the other side if you want. And then there's one for diaper changes. You put like when they were and if it was just like wet or mixed or whatever. And then sleep too. So I have to leave for my appointment at 12. So my hope is that she eats until 11:30, and then I have like a half an hour to kind of like burp her and get all my stuff together. Okay.
Ugh, my gosh.
Ew, my hair is so disgusting. There's so much oil in it. There's this technique I learned to do this, to burp them. Sometimes it, I feel like most of the time it works. You have a big booger in your nose. Okay, I'm gonna see if she's still hungry. Well, she just ate for like another 8 minutes. Wake up. Oh, there we go. Sometimes she wakes up if I do that. Wake up. Oh, she's trying to open her eyes. Here you go.
Hello.
Can you put her down at like 12:15?
Yep.
She's not really enjoying it. She probably still needs to be like burped and stuff. She didn't burp or anything.
It's uncomfortable.
Yeah, I'd maybe keep her upright for a little bit.
Yeah.
Hi.
Hello.
Okay, so she has been awesome today. So I'm back from my appointment, and obviously it's been 2.5 hours since I last fed her, and that's when I like to feed her, every 2.5 hours. Like that's from like the start of one to then the start of the next. So I'm gonna go wake her up, do the same, routine as you just saw. Yeah, that's basically just every day. You just do the same cycle all day. My goal for after feeding her is then to do my nails and to do them as quickly as possible, or at least start my nails. I do my own dip, I already said that. And the process is long. So sometimes it takes like 2 naps to do my nails. Thankfully with dip, you don't like have to wait for them to dry. So if I do like one hand and then do the other hand later, that's fine. Okay, gonna wake her up, feed her, and then we'll do my nails. I just had to come over here and show you guys her sweet girl. Okay. I am like so happy with how well she's been sleeping today. Not necessarily all the other days. Oh, Kyle made the bed. Just realized, what a good husband. Get the tootsies out. Mm-hmm. That's my girl. By the way, this swaddle is the best swaddle. It's a miracle swaddle. It has these little flaps that like go tuck under their arms, so it like really pins their arms down. I feel like other swaddles, it's like you can wrap their arms around, but every time I do that, she like somehow makes her way out.
You just farted on me.
She has so many farts. There have been already many times before I would release all of her gas before a change, where during the change she farts and a bunch of poop comes out with it and poop just shoots out.
I love little baby feet.
Are you Okay, I'm about to be a meme mom. I'm gonna pick her boogers. This thing is, I love it. I'm so obsessed with it. It is like oddly satisfying getting her boogers out of her nose. So she just fed on one side for like 19 minutes. Pretty sure that she fell asleep. I have mascara on my, probably. This is gonna wake her up. It's literally like right in the front. It's not like I'm like shoving this thing back into her face. Ugh! Lovely. I am picking your boogers with a stick and you are still not waking up. Why are you so sleepy today? What is this? What we've learned is bad awake time in the day. So like no awake time means not so great sleep at night. So we need her to be up when it's time for awake time. Wake up. Whoop, whoop. Do, 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 do. Do, 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 do. Ah! Ah! Tickle, tickle, tickle.
She got side. Nope. Okay.
Oh, there you go! You're awake! Woohoo! Oh, don't fall asleep. There we go. Nope, don't fall asleep. Are you still hungry? Usually if she's like chewing her fingers, that means that she's still hungry. Yeah, she's chewing her fingers. Okay, well that's what oh, ew, there's spit up over here. That's what happens when you fall asleep during feeding. Okay. I'm gonna feed her more.
Okay, I finished feeding her. Oh my gosh, she fell asleep again. Maisie, I'm gonna put her down. I'll show you what I do. So, we turn the lights off.
I'm gonna go turn on her sound machine. I put down her burp cloth where her head is just in case she spits up. We don't want that on the bed.
So I talked about it in my last video, but we do at the same time with like do. We do the Taking Care of Babies sleep program, which is incredible and I highly, highly recommend it. And one of the things that she teaches is an acronym called CRIES, which is just a way to like calm the baby when you put them down. I think it's mainly meant for like if they're like fussing to get them to calm. But even if I swaddle her and she's not fussing, I still like to do it because I feel like it at least just kind of like soothes her for a bit. Put that on my app that she just fell asleep. And then the goal is to wake her up 2:45, 3:45, 4:15. So about an hour and 25 minutes. So it's nail time. I'm trying something new with my nails. Whenever I do dip, I usually just like do like one color dip. But I saw this on Instagram and I feel like I could do it. So I wanna do this, like where it like gradually goes down the finger, but with yellow. I'm first going to soak off what I have with acetone. Well, it's 3:30 and she woke up early, and I knew that she would because she didn't stay awake. So it's 45 minutes earlier than what we wanted her to do. That's okay. This is what happens sometimes. So, I mean, unless she's like super hungry, we are just gonna keep her awake for a little bit until 4:15, and that's when I'd wanna feed her. But if she's like rooting or something, then I'll feed her.
Well, we just had quite the experience.
As you can tell, I'm in different clothes because she threw up everywhere. I ended up feeding her because she wouldn't stop crying. And she did a good feed, and then she threw up everywhere. We had to change her. And I had to change my shirt and my pants. Okay, I just wanted to update you all, but I'm gonna calm her down now. Okay, baby's down. So, it's 5 o'clock. We just got our dinner dropped off, so we have been doing a meal train. Tonight is actually our last meal train meal. So we had it for every other day for a month, and it's been a month now.
It's the end of an era.
But we got some food from someone who goes to our church who is like, amazing cook. So we're gonna eat, but I also really want to finish my nails. That's just kind of the thing with being a mom now is, I feel like anything you wanna do, you have to be prepared to stop what you're doing and get back to it later. I feel like every day I give myself like one, maybe like two things that I wanna do that day, because I feel like that's really all you can do. Whether that's like, I wanna edit a video, I wanna do my nails, I wanna do a tan, whatever that is, because there's so much like start and stop. My things today were, I just want to vlog and I wanna do my nails. I have about an hour until I wanna wake her up again to feed her, and then we're gonna do bath and everything, so. So I just fed her. I have one hand done. Can't show it. So far, Maisie hates baths.
This baths, I was taking a bath, but I don't
know. Woo! Ew, your butt stinks, Maisie. Yay! Let's be happy.
Welcome to the vlog. I'm about to take a bath. I'm gonna go get ready for my bath, and I'll be right back. Catch you in a second.
Last night, I tried to play music during her bath. Didn't work. We've tried some different temperature, water temperatures. Nothing changes. They say to put your elbow in it, and if your elbow's comfortable, then you're good. Just a foot? Is it bad? Pretty cool.
Yeah.
Did mom's trick work? Oh my gosh, I think it worked. I think it worked. Are you liking it? My idea was to just put her feet in first, let her kind of touch the water, and then put the rest of her body in. And it worked.
Ooh. Initiate screaming.
No, she's so good. She looks shocked. She like doesn't know what to do.
How do you zoom?
Don't zoom, just put it closer to her face. It's like the difference between this cry and all the other cries is like, you can tell she's crying because she didn't like the bath. Where like other cries are like gas or I'm hungry or something. Yeah. This is like it's so.
Why would you do this to me?
Yes, it's exactly what her face is. So this is an owlet sock, and it basically tracks her heart rate and her oxygen level. And it just velcros onto her foot. You turn the light off and her sound machine on. So we're trying to like create like a bedtime routine where after we feed her, we do her bath, I put her in her PJs, and I read to her. And I actually think she might still be hungry. She's trying to eat her fingers, and that means you're hungry. I feel like she's not really old enough to comprehend that I'm reading a book to her. Do you think it even makes sense to add a book into the night routine?
Yeah, I mean, I was trying to do things even when I was doing like the tummy tuck on my chest, like that's what I was doing with my hands, to get her to like feel like to look and like visualize like things. Like get like attention to things, like for the first month. Is great.
So try to get so, like, attention to the
book. If you have like a toy that makes noise and you shake it over here and she looks at it, like that's, she's doing good.
Okay. It's time for bed, little goose. The stars are out and on the loose. She's not looking at the pictures. It's time for bed, little. What's that word? Bow, little cow. Did you hear me?
kind of has little. What's that word?
What's a foul? F-O-A-L? Is that the name for a baby horse? She doesn't care what I say. Okay, next page. So it's now 7:30, 3 hours from her like dinner time feeding. So around like 6, 7 or whatever that feeding, that's when we do a dream feed. The dream feed we do in the room in the dark and don't do any awake time after. And then after the 9:15 one, that's just when we let her sleep and she wakes us up. We got that approved by the doctor. The doctor said, just let her sleep because she's gaining weight really well. Because I know a lot of people have been like, no, you still need to feed them every 2 to 3 hours. But our doctor told us to just let her sleep if she wants to sleep. And she'll wake us up when she does. And she usually wakes up like 3 to 4 hours, 3 to maybe 4.5 hours from first feeding to the next feeding. I'll show you guys the nighttime. That will be very interesting. I'm going to vlog the whole night too. I'm going to start getting ready for bed while I wait for that to heat up. Oh, I have to show you my nails. The thumb is full and then it's like 3/4 and then these always, both of these look the same. I didn't really mean for that to happen. Can't tell if I love it or if I hate it, but I feel like it's really fun and like if you have like rings on, but I, like all my tan came off. I feel like with my tan, it's like I'm like tan and all of a sudden like I'm just like, I like don't look tan one day and I'm like, what the heck? So then I'm gonna put like a bit on my face and neck tonight. So I just got this cleansing balm, the Spy Burst, and it just takes off my makeup and then I go in with a cleanser. And I'm kind of wondering if maybe this is the thing that like made me break out. I love how it takes my makeup off, but if it's making me break out, I'm not gonna keep doing it. I feel like my face always, oh my gosh. There's a huge fly on my camera. That is massive. I bet I could catch that, but then I'd like break my camera. I think I just decided I'm going to do an overnight tan. I wasn't gonna do that because we just got new sheets and they're like really nice and I don't wanna ruin them, but I don't think I will. I don't like that I have like yellow nails and being so like pasty. I feel like you need to be a little more tan for that. Tanning for during breastfeeding, I like basically don't put the tan on my boobs. Like I kind of just stop and I like go like around so that she's not like pressing against it or like obviously eating it or anything. So I'm about to wake her up, but I want to show you like how I prep for the evening. I literally look like I have dirt all over my face. So I have my Hydro Flask filled with water and this gets filled probably a couple times in the night. And then I have 2 burp cloths because just in case she spits up, I want to have another one with me so I don't have to get up and go get one. And then I have 2 really long things of toilet paper because my allergies have been horrible and I've been blowing my nose like crazy at night. And then I just have a claw clip here in case I need it to put my hair up or like pin my shirt up or something. And then I just folded a bunch of like single paper towels and then I put them here into the diaper drawer. And I use those paper towels because so often she just starts like peeing while I'm changing her. And so even if I have like a diaper underneath her, for some reason it just gets all over the changing pad. And so I just use those to wipe it up. I'm now gonna go wake her up and I'm gonna feed her in the dark. And then what I wanted to do throughout the night was just tell you guys like what time I'm waking up and like how long it took and just kind of that. I'm not gonna be like filming like me feeding and changing her and stuff every time, but just kind of giving you an idea of what a night would look like with the newborn. Hello. It's so weird to be vlogging in the middle of the night. So she woke up at like, I'm trying to be quiet because Kyle's asleep. So she woke up at like 12:15, which is only like 2 hours and 45 minutes. Which is kind of abnormal for her. Usually, like,
the first stretch of the night, so this one.
I feel like it's usually like the longest.
Like this one's usually like the 4 hour one or 3.5 hours or something. And I'll let you know what time she wakes up next. Seriously, you just look like I have dirt all over my face. Hello again. So she woke up around like 3:45 and it was kind of like, oh my gosh, so bright. Maybe like a 3 hour, 15 minute stretch. It kind of seemed like she just like kept waking up and like grunting and was like super uncomfortable. I don't know if she was just making noises, but it kind of seemed like it was like a gas grunt. I think at one point she woke up and I checked my phone. It had only been like 2 hours. And then I think she just fell back asleep. Like she was let out a few cries and a lot of grunts and stuff. And then, yeah, then I think she fell back asleep. It didn't last very long. Like I didn't let her just like cry for a super long time or anything. My back is killing me right now. I'm blowing my nose like crazy. Like it feels like I have a cold or something. Yeah, I'm not really feeling too hot right now. And I'm not sleeping well. I felt like I just kept waking up and like I never fully went to bed. I think it's because she kept like waking up and making all these like grunting noises. And so it's like all I was thinking about. Okay, I'm back. This is the same feeding that I was just filming. I was just trying to like calculate out like her feedings before we have to go somewhere in the morning. So I realized I can't really let her do her own like longer stretches right now because we have to leave the house between 9:15 and like 9:25. So that means I have to feed her at like 8:30 because I like to feed her right before we go so that she sleeps for the time that we're out. And she started this feed at 3:45. And it's currently like 4 o'clock. She's not going to sleep until 8:30. I mean, she could, but I definitely do not want to risk that because that would be the longest stretch she's ever done. So that basically means I have to wake up at like 6:30 to feed her and then feed her again at 8:30. So that's kind of what I have to do, which kind of sucks. But okay, so it's now the next morning, or not the next morning, it's just a few hours after my last feeding. I just do my makeup, but I haven't really looked at it, so I don't really know if it's like messy or not, so it's fun. So I woke up at 6:30 to feed her, and then I got ready, or started getting ready. I was able to take a shower and wash my hair, and then she started crying at, what was it, like 8 o'clock? My goal was to feed her at 8:30 because we need to leave the house at 8:15. Or at 9:15, so if I fed her for a half an hour and then 15 minutes to get out of the house. But she woke up early. So when I picked her up, she was like totally calm. And so I was like, okay, well maybe I'll just like keep holding you and keep getting ready, try to. And so I literally just sat down in front of my mirror and did my makeup with her swaddled in my lap. And she's just so content. But then she started crying again, so now I'm feeding her. Everything is just timed out. It's like you're trying to time out your whole life now. And sometimes it goes to plan and sometimes it doesn't, but it's a beautiful thing and I love it and she's the best. So I'm gonna end it here because after this feeding I'm gonna rush to finish getting ready and then we're gonna get out of the house. Yeah, this is fun, just vlogging like 24 hours of what it's like in a day with Molly and Maisie. Okay, thanks for watching, love you guys, see you in my next one, bye.